गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ अभिषेक शर्मा फ्रॉम माउंट लिटरेसी स्कूल झांसी। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद आर न्यू चैप्टर इन क्लास 11th स्टैटिक्स, चैप्टर 8, अर्थमेटिक लाइंस ग्राफ्स टाइम सीरीज ग्राफ्स। सो टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ग्राफ्स। व्हेन अ सेट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिकल डेटा आर प्रेजेंटेड ऑन अ ग्राफ पेपर, इट इज कॉल्ड अ ग्राफ। Presenting the data on a graph paper, we get different points, each points corresponding to a value of a statistical series. By joining the points, we get a line which shows how a variable tends to change. Each points on the line correspond to an arithmetic value of the variable under study, like, for example, the value of export, import. Therefore, a graph showing arithmetic values of a variable is called arithmetic line graph. Often such graphs are constructed to present time series data, that is the data corresponding to different weeks, month or the year. Therefore, arithmetic line groups are often called as time series graph. Construction of a graph. Keeping in mind the size and nature of data, a suitable intersecting points on the graph paper is assumed as a point of origin, as point O in the adjacent diagram. Horizontal and vertical lines intersecting through the points are known as bold lines. These bold lines are known or called as axes. Horizontal line from left to right is called horizontal axis, abscissa or x-axis, whereas the line growing upward or downward is called as vertical axis, ordinates or y-axis. So students, the x-axis and the y-axis are mutually perpendicular to each other. These axes divide the plane of the paper in four parts. Each part is known as quadrants. As in the graph given on which we have discussed, that's the point. So there are some rules relating to the construction of graph. Basically, there are 8. And we will going to discuss one by one. First of all, heading. Every graph must have a suitable, precise and appropriate heading, and it should be self-explanatory. Choice of scale. One should fix an appropriate scale on which data should be presented. Proportion of x-axis. As far as possible, the length of x-axis on the graph paper should be 1.5 times the length of y-axis. Method of plotting the points. Lines of different types. If more than one line or curve are to be drawn in the same graph, these lines should be differentiated from each other in the form of broken line, dotted line and bold lines and many more. Table of data. It would be useful to give table of data along with the graph of the data. This helps in verification of the graph. Use of false baselines. If the values in a series are very large and in the difference between the smallest value and zero is high, and if these values are to be indicated on y-axis of the graph, then y-axis is started somewhere above the point O. Whereas when these lines are on x-axis, we overcome this difficulty by showing a cut or knick on y-axis. If these values are to be indicated on x-axis, then there should be a cut or knick in the marked on the x-axis. This means when you are showing these lines on the x-axis, there should be a cut or knick, and when should you are showing them in a y value, it should be above the point O. The last is to draw a line or a curve. Students, we mark different points on the graph paper corresponding to different values of a series. These points are joined to make a line or a curve. The joining line must be uniform throughout its length. It should not be of different thickness as its different points. So students, these were the some rules associated or connected with construction of graph. Heading, choice of scale, proportion of axes, method of plotting, lines of different types, table of data, use of false base lines, and to draw a line or curve. So that's all for today's classes. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे।